So what you will do in this video is now a default value is added, right? So first of all, let's just seed the data. Seed all. So what it will do, it will seed the data. Seed user migration. I'm trying to insert the same data. So obviously unique is true. So update this JSON, data JSON to something else, because I already seed some data. Either you can delete that data and then you can try. Okay, I can delete one by one only. Let's just do the route here. I'm just showing all this because I wanted to make you clear about different aspects which I can show in the demo. DB migrate and then DB seed all. Right, so here you can see now in the users data has been added. Right, so similarly, because email is unique, right? So if you try to insert the same thing again, DB seed all, then what it will happen, it will try to break this because you are seeding same data. So in that case, when you do the bulk insert, you always need to be careful. If you are trying to run it again, then it will break. So you can just check if data is already there, do not insert, just update that data. All these utilities are available on query interface object. Okay, so this is how we write migrations and seeders, and this is how we run it. So you can automate that using package.json. Write some command in package.json, npm run create, npm run drop, npm run seed, npm run. All these can be added in the package.json. That is the better way of doing it. Now, how can we define the association? So user is there, right? User, this is the place where we will define the associations for the user. And now we don't need to worry about models, which I forgot to talk about, right? Models are now not required. Why? Because I'm running the migrations and I'm just creating the schema models through the migrations. So I'm not using this db.sync at all. I'm not using it, right? So if you're not using, then how you can do the connections and all? So for that, you need to go to the old school code and get that snippet. I mean, obviously we need to get the connections using my connection object. So just put it here instead of this. But we don't need a sync utility. Connection.sync we don't need because migration is taking care of that. So this particular models folder we can totally remove. And we can just check using the connect utility. There is a connect we did is about to check the connection. Connection.authenticate, that is fine, just to check if your credentials are okay. We are able to connect to the database, so we'll just put it here. I think we have closed everything properly. Card DB root root. So here, Sequelize, right? This is how we will get the connection object. So you can also copy it somewhere and get the connection object, connection.authenticate and dot them. But you have to sync. How can I get all the schema model object in the Sequelize object? I mean, if I do right now connections, or if I just try to get the user and user dot find by ID or update and all these queries, then how user will get all those methods? So for that, we need to sync all these schema models with the connection object or the Sequelize. Okay, so on top of that, let's see how we can define the associations, like create user, right? So create user, what we can do is user dot has many. User dot has many context. So this place we will use the associations. Association place we will use to define the relationship between the different schema models. So here we have seen that running migrations. So whenever you migrate, you actually get a place where you can also define your associations. So up and down, right? That is fine. So You can also do, I mean, the same thing. You can also create a Sequelize RC file where you can define where is your config folder. I mean, if you wanted to put your config.json somewhere else, your seeders, migrations, and models folder somewhere else, then you can put it. So it will take care of your models. So we are maintaining two things here, models and migrations. Models is just a replica, and models we are using just to get all the Sequelize object there. So this code is required if we are actually going to execute this particular code. And we also need models folder with that index.js, because we will be able to query, because we are not using sequelize.sync file. Always make it false as a false, because we are not going to do anything with that, right? We are not going to alter any database. Sequelize.model.sync, what it will do, it will copy all the models in the Sequelize object so that you will be able to execute query. So models, you will get the models from here. You just need to create the same way and just define all your models inside this. Okay, so in the next video, what we will see how we can do the associations in these Sequelize migrations. So models will have just only column definitions, that's it, right? But the actual definition of the tables will be done in the migrations.